I think he's truly a hero. I feel for the family, but I also know that they at least know that he died saving his child.
A father loses his life fighting to free his 8-year-old daughter from a powerful rip current pulling them into the Gulf. The body of 46-year-old Thomas Zakruski was found in the water after that search you saw hours later. Good evening, I'm Kelly Burns.
And I'm Peter Bush. Our team of reporters have been following this story since we broke the news of the search last night off Upper Captiva Island. NBC2 just got this exclusive video. Lee County deputies were searching for Zakruski from the air. Investigators say Zakruski was able to swim his daughter into his mother's arms, or her mother's arms, before he disappeared beneath the surface. NBC2's Christina Mendez is on the island tonight walking you through how this tragedy unfolded.
The family was attempting to cross this area where water is flowing in between these two mounds of sand, but instead the current was so strong that it ripped the father away from this area and out to the Gulf.
Waves washing in and out, pulling sand, shells, and sea life with it. Just as quick as the tides change, so can your safety.
Tough walk. It knocked my daughter down.
Bobby Greco and his girls are talking about the trek across this sandbar in Upper Captiva.
If it was waist level, a little bit higher, they'd probably pull me in.
The same spot where 46-year-old Thomas Zakruski and his family walked last night. But not everyone from the Georgia family made it across alive.
The father was enjoying the water with his daughter, I believe. It became apparent that they were caught in some type of a strong current.
Thomas was able to pass his 8-year-old daughter to his wife to bring to the safety of the shore, a selfless act. But in seconds, he was lost under the waves and nowhere in sight. Sergeant Russell Park says sandbars are known to keep the company of rip currents.
Pay particular attention to areas around sandbars. The water's coming in, it's got to go out somewhere. But you can't always see it.
After several different agencies searched the water for hours, his body was found along the beach. As a father of two, Greco can't imagine.
Really sad coming out here with your family to enjoy, but strong, you gotta be careful.
LCSO urges you to be aware of the weather and any alerts that are in place while you are in the water. Last night, there was a rip current warning in effect.
Wait until the conditions improve. Don't risk it. It's not worth risking anybody's life.
The sheriff's office says the best advice if you are caught in a rip current is to first stay calm and then swim parallel to the shore, but never fight a rip current. It will tire you out. And if you're watching from land, the sheriff's office says to call for help. Don't attempt to go in the water and save that person. Reporting in Upper Captiva, Christina Mendez, NBC2.
We have told you about two other water rescues off the barrier islands just over the past couple of weeks. On July 2nd, two 10-year-old cousins fell off jet skis near the Sanibel Causeway. The current carried them to one of the pillars under the bridge where they held on until deputies could save them. Those kids are okay. Then on June 28th, Tia Izazari was caught in the current from Blind Pass while she was swimming off Captiva's Turner Park. Her husband tried to save her. He got swept away as well. A deputy got there in time to pull them both from the water.